What are the differences between permissionless and permissioned blockchains? And which is best for your business? Hello, and welcome to the Akeo Tech Channel, where business and technology go hand in hand. My name is Louis Procopio, and today we're going to continue our blockchain discussion with permissionless versus permissioned. Last week, we had a quick introduction into what a blockchain is and how it works. Check out this video here if you haven't seen it already. This week, we're going to answer the following questions. What are the differences between a permissionless and a permissioned blockchain, and which is best for your business? Generally, the answer to which blockchain is best would be completely subjective. But here at Akeo Tech, we're not talking about things in general terms. We are talking about things in business terms. So I think today we'll be able to be a little bit objective about how we attack this question, which is best for your business. You may have an existing business, maybe you have a startup, maybe you just have an idea. To find out which blockchain suits you best, we need to first understand the nuances between them. Let's begin with the first of the two, permissionless, also known as public or decentralized blockchains. As we go over the characteristics, I want you to consider if these would be pros or cons according to your business model. Okay, so permissionless blockchains, anyone can access and create data. Anyone can create and publish smart contracts. Anyone can run a node. 100% transparent, so you can read everything. There's a relatively high level of anonymity. Performance is slow. Scaling is a massive challenge. There are monetary incentives for those running nodes, and because of the nature of the proof of work consensus algorithm, permissionless blockchains use an incredible amount of energy. The most obvious examples of permissionless blockchains today are, of course, the Bitcoin and the Ethereum blockchain. Very decentralized, very secure, very slow, and open to anyone with a web connection and a web-enabled device. So that was permissionless, now permissioned blockchains, also known as private or centralized. Okay, so permissioned blockchains, they are closed ecosystems where all participants are well-defined. Only pre-approved entities can run nodes. The degrees of decentralization and transparency are completely up to the company or companies running and configuring the blockchain. There's no anonymity. It does not require mining to validate transactions or execute smart contracts. It does not require a crypto economic incentive or tokens for those running nodes. And consensus mechanisms are computationally inexpensive, allowing permission blockchains to perform and scale much better than permissionless. So to quickly summarize, both are distributed secure databases, but each with its own distinct capabilities, philosophy, and adoption affordability. Permissionless blockchains enjoy freedom in decentralization, and permissioned blockchains enjoy freedom in configurational flexibility. So which is best for your business? You and your company aspire to leverage blockchain technology. You want to increase efficiency, and you are drawn to the immutable and the trustless nature of the blockchain. Unfortunately, there is no one right answer, but if I can help steer you in a general direction. Permissioned blockchains are a great place to start if you have a B2B business model. If your business model includes crypto economics, then a great place to start your blockchain journey would be the permissionless route. But that's just me, so let me know if you agree or disagree, if you have anything to add, or if you have any questions, let us know. But before we wrap this up, I want to leave you with a little critical thinking question. Permissionless blockchains like Bitcoin and Ethereum incentivize people for running network nodes. There is no blockchain without nodes. So my question for you is, in a permissioned blockchain, what are the primary incentives for those running nodes? I'm curious to hear what you guys come up with, so if you dare, please share your answers in the comment section below. If you're really interested in learning more about how blockchain is being used today and what problems businesses are trying to solve with this technology, then head on over to akeo.tech, where you can download our free blockchain guide for business professionals. If you like what we're doing here, be sure to subscribe to our channel and hit that thumbs up button. Let us know if you have any questions or if you just want to say hi. Thank you. I'll see you next week when we talk about the world's most popular permission blockchain. It's open source. It's private. It's Hyperledger Fabric. Bye-bye. And affordable adoption affordability.